Here are all of the ingredients we need to make our cookies. We have some flour, and this is regular white flour. And then I like to add just a little bit of whole wheat flour to it. We have just some regular white sugar, light brown sugar in this bag over here, baking soda, salt, butter, and this is one of my favorite butters. This Irish Kerrygold butter is really, really good. This is the salted kind, so I may not add as much salt, because this already has a bit of salt in it. And we need our pumpkin pie spice. You can add just the individual spices. This one has cinnamon, ginger, nutmeg, allspice in it. You could add the individual spices as well, but I figure since I do have this pumpkin pie spice, I might as well use it. Ground cloves as well. Vanilla extract. Semi-sweet chocolate chips. Our pumpkin. Eggs. And then I also have this buttercream frosting. You don't have to do this, I just kind of wanted to try it, see how it tastes. But that's it, let's get started on the first step. So the first thing we have to do is prepare our pumpkin puree. And you could just buy like a can of pumpkin. You don't have to do the whole fresh pumpkin thing, but I kind of wanted to do the fresh pumpkin. So we preheat the oven to 350 degrees, and we have to cut off the top and then slice this in half. Now we have to scoop out all of the insides of this pumpkin. Okay, so now that we have our pumpkin gutted out, I'm gonna take it and put it onto this foil covered cookie sheet. And once the oven is finished preheating, I'll throw it in there for about 45 minutes. So this is the pumpkin after it comes out of the oven. And after you strip it away from the skin, it sort of looks kind of stringy. And in order to make it into a nice puree, you can put it through like a food processor. However, I'm just going to put it in to the mixer as is, and I'm going to use 1 cup. If I have extra, which I probably will, I'm going to put it into a little baggie and put it in the freezer, and I think it keeps for like 6 months or something. So you can keep using your pumpkin for almost half a year after baking it. So in this separate bowl here, I'm going to put all of the dry ingredients together and mix them all. Starting with flour. So 1 cup of the white flour, and then I'm gonna do about a half a cup. And I'm going to use the rest as whole wheat. So 3 cups total of the flour. Two teaspoons of baking soda. That's one. Small amount of salt because the butter I'm using is salted, so I'm just gonna use like a little bit, like a pinch almost of salt. Then I'm going to do 2 teaspoons of the pumpkin pie spice, which so I'm gonna use a smaller teaspoon, the 1/2 I think might fit. Let's see. Yeah. 2 teaspoons might be too much, so I'm just gonna do that amount. 1 1/2 teaspoons of the pumpkin pie spice, and then I'm going to do 1/4 teaspoon of the cloves. Okay, so we're gonna put the 2 sticks of butter into our mixer, and we're going to mix it until it's nice and smooth and creamy. You're gonna wanna use really softened butter. If your butter is still kind of frozen, you can put it on the stove while the pumpkin's cooking, and that'll kind of make it nice and soft. You have to watch it a little bit though, because sometimes it can start to melt, so just watch it. Once the butter is nice and creamy, I'm gonna put in the white and brown sugar, a cup of each, and I'm just gonna slowly put it in there a little bit at a time until it's nice and light and fluffy. Next, I'm gonna put in each egg one at a time. And again, just mix it all together until it's nice and mixed. Next, I'm going to add the 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract and the 1 cup of pumpkin. I'm gonna make sure that's really nice and mixed so that it doesn't look really stringy. And after that, I can take all of the dry ingredients, the flour, baking soda, salt, the pumpkin pie spice, and the cloves, and just slowly add that into it and make sure that it's mixing right. And then the final step is to add the chocolate chips, and I'm just going to use an entire bag, 12-ounce bag of semi-sweet chocolate chips. And now I'm just going to spread them out onto these cookie sheets. I'm not sure how much they're gonna spread. These are pretty large, so I'm gonna try some big ones, and then I'll try some small ones, so we'll see how they work. Okay, so these are the big ones, and then I'll make a sheet of smaller ones. This is just some regular parchment paper. And these are going to go in the oven for, I think, about 15 minutes. I don't know, we'll see how they cook. And yeah, I preheated the oven to 350, and let's hope these guys turn out good. All right, the first batch is finished. I let them cool for a little bit so they wouldn't be so soft, and they look pretty good. Not bad. I'm gonna have to transfer them over to this paper here. And then let them cool a bit longer. Not burned, that's a good sign. Okay, I still have two cookie sheets in the oven, but I can't wait to try these. So I think these are cool enough. They feel very moist, but still like solid, obviously like a cookie. They have a very soft texture, kind of like a cake. I don't know. They're just bursting with all sorts of different flavors. The spice, the chocolate, the pumpkin, it tastes really, really good. It would be really tasty with like some milk. But I think they're a success. They're really tasty. I wish I could share them with you guys. But thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I've gotten a lot of requests for cooking or baking related videos. So this is my first attempt at one. I hope it was halfway decent. So thank you again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.